What are the side effects of BPC-157? Now, this is something that everybody should take note of, because with anything that's really good, you have to look at the trade-off. And so in medicine, we always say, do the risks outweigh the benefits? And then there's the famous quote by William Osler. He is the academic dean at the Yale School of Medicine. And what he says is, in medicine, there's always two cures, one for the disease and one for the treatment of the disease. But I learned, like, I don't want to have that second cure. I just want that first thing to help the body heal itself. So the big cure that BPC can provide is helping your body heal itself. But there are some risks. And in this video, I'm going to go deep into how you can mitigate these risks, what the risks are, and hopefully shed some light on some, you know, very interesting parts of BPC-157 that most doctors overlook, most biohackers overlook, and even people in the bodybuilding community haven't really addressed. And so let's dive in. BPC, the thing about it is it's generally well tolerated and it's got minimal side effects. I mean, the beautiful thing, and I should say adverse side effects. So a side effect of any drug or any molecule can be a positive side effect. But generally in this video, as I talk about side effects, I'll be talking about adverse outcomes or things that we don't want to have happen, also known as negative side effects. And BPC, as long as you're getting it from a compounding pharmacy, a licensed 503A or 503B compounding pharmacy, you're getting the real thing, and it's going to be sterilized properly. If you're using it as an injection, you can mitigate the risk by using the alcohol wipes, wipe the top of your bottle, wipe your skin, make sure it's clean, and then inject it in the proper way. Outside of that, there's very low risk of having any kind of contamination. But the problem is, over 80% of the research that we did, my team and I, what we found is that the BPC-157 is coming from a non-pharmaceutical grade source. So it may be from a research facility. So if you're ever purchasing peptides and it's not through a doctor, it's not prescriptive based, then you're probably filling out a form that says, okay, I am a research facility, and you're taking liability on yourself. But a lot of companies now, I see that they've got these BPC-157 frags and it's not the real thing, but they're marketing as such. You got to be careful, because not all BPC-157 is created equal. And that can pose risks. It's risks that we don't know. BPC-157, it was discovered in early 1990s out of Croatia. And what they found is that every cell in the body had receptors for BPC. They found it was naturally made by the stomach excretions. So human gastric secretions are where this peptide comes from. But they found that it helped heal connective tissue damage. It also helped activate neuroplasticity. It helped with angiogenesis. They just found that it was like a Swiss Army knife molecule. And they studied it for colitis. They studied it for neuroregeneration. They also took these rabbits and they damaged the Achilles tendon. And they found that it helped a lot with that. They also found in subsequent studies, they took patients who had injuries from steroidal overuse. So maybe they had had too many of the corticosteroid injections in the knees. And some of you probably had these injections and didn't even know what your doctor was injecting. But if you ever get an injection in an area where you've got pain and the pain subsides pretty dramatically, usually it's a corticosteroid injection. And so this cortisone injections can damage the joint. It's like putting battery acid in your joint, and then you get these little osteophytes that can develop. But BPC-157 can help mitigate a lot of the damage from overuse of these corticosteroidal injections. And we've also seen where it can do the same. If you take like rounds of prednisone, for example, maybe you've got an autoimmune disease and you have to suppress the inflammatory response, like an RA, well, BPC-157 can help heal up those damaged blood vessels from suppressing the immune function. But outside of that, BPC-157 is working more with your body's own natural rhythms. It's not like a drug that comes in and just suppresses a function. And in one of the clinical trials, they assessed the safety and the efficacy of BPC-157 in healthy volunteers. And what they found is it was very well tolerated. There's no significant adverse effects reported. And their suggestion was it has a very safe profile when administered under the control of physicians. And so this study will provide a link in the show notes. The other thing is, you know, there are some mild and rare reactions. Some of those, they've talked about how they got dizziness, they have slight nausea, and then they've had temporary changes in appetite or digestion. These are uncommon and they're very transient, like they go away very quickly. The other side effect that you have to be aware of is you may get some local irritation where you inject the BPC. Sometimes you can get a little bit of a rash or discomfort in the area that it's injected. And once again, if you follow the instructions on exactly how to inject it, you want to make sure you're cleaning the areas. Typically, these are minimal side effects. The interesting thing about this is we had one of our clients, the only person that I've seen have a side effect with BPC-157, and she talked very openly about this, is she had a condition called CIRS, or chronic inflammatory reaction syndrome. She had Lyme disease, she had multiple chemical sensitivities, and as she started using BPC-157, what she found is it did trigger, I think it was the anti-inflammatory response from the BPC and maybe the cell signaling, the nitric oxide. It almost made that the CIRS flare up, and she had a temporary flare. We pulled her off the BPC and everything went back down to normal, but we realized we had to work on immune modulation before we could use BPC-157. It was a very important lesson, because now when we see people who they are in like a thyroid storm or an autoimmune storm, we know that thymosin alpha 1 is a phenomenal peptide. It's made by your thymus gland, and it regulates the response of the immune system so that your body's not so reactive to any little input. And I think that's the danger, is a lot of people with these autoimmune conditions that Western medicine doesn't really have any answers for, they just throw too many things at their body and there's too many inputs that they have to deal with, and then they almost make things worse. And with this client, however, it's very rare. We've had other clients respond really well for BPC, even if they've had CIRS. But once we got her on the thymosin alpha 1, her immune system downregulated. We had Dr. Steinle doing exosomes and stem cell treatments, and that calmed down and remodulated her immune system even more. And 30 days later, she tried BPC-157 again. She said, I've heard how powerful this peptide is. And then she was actually able to experience the benefits. She noticed her digestion improved. She was getting more nutrients in. She started gaining weight. She lost the dizziness, and she had a recovery in her strength. So as you're looking at the risk profile, the number one way you can mitigate the risk is work with a team of professionals. Now, my company, you can go to agelessfuture.com. We've got phenomenal practitioners who are all trained in functional medicine and applying their functional medicine principles to your peptide protocols. And then we put you on what we call the Ageless Future Operating System, where we clarify the goals that you want in your life. We predict where you can go once the diagnosis is established. And then we help rejuvenate your body on a regular basis by making sure that you've got the right lifestyle and habits in place so that you can benefit the most from these peptides. And so for those of you who say, man, I want to learn more and more about BPC-157, then you're going to want to check out my video on, do I need a prescription for BPC-157? I'm Regan Archibald. Happy that you're here. Thanks for being part of our community, and I'll see you in the next video.